Hello everyone, in this video we will see the question that is maximum product sub array. It is a question of read code 152 and it is a medium level question. So in this we are given an integer array numbers. Find the contiguous sub array within an array containing at least one number which has the largest product. So the question is telling us to find a sub array. So basically what is sub array? Sub array is the contiguous array, that is the elements who are in contiguous index or continuous indexes, that is 0, 1, 2, 3. So it may not, it is not like we multiply 2 with the element at index 4. So it should be like index are continuous, no index is missing between them. So that is sub array. So for and we have to find the maximum product of a sub array. So it may be that the sub array is having a single element that is having more value than the product of the sub array. So the single element also may be our result. So in this array, that is 2, 3 and minus 2 and 4, we are having the maximum product as 2 into 4 or 2 into 3, that is 6. So if you multiply 6 into minus 2, it becomes minus 12. So it is lesser, and 4 is also lesser, the single index. So if you multiply 4 also with minus 12, so it will be lesser. So that's why the result is 6. In this array, that is minus 2, 0 and minus 1, the maximum product that we can get is 0, because minus 2 is less than 0 and minus 1 is also less than 0, and if you multiply any of them with 0, so the result will be 0. So that's why the 0 is maximum product sub array. So I will show you the three approaches to approach this question. If you are asked in an interview this question, then how should you approach this question? First of all, you should start with a brute force approach, that is using three nested loops. So why we use three nested loops? So basically for finding the sub array, we have to use two loops, that is I and j. For I will run from 0 to n minus 1, and j will run from I, that is from I to n minus 1. So that is the purpose of I and j. And to find the product of that sub array that I and j consist of, we use another loop, that is k. So k runs from I to j. So if the I is at 0th index and j is at third index, at second index, then k will find the product of elements from I to j. So that is 2 into 3 into minus 2. That's how it works. And then for every j index, j for loop, the every iteration of j for loop, we initialize our temp variable to 1 and we save the product of all the sub array elements in the temp variable, and we update the result variable that we have to return, the maximum product. We set it to the maximum of the previous result that we are having and the temporary variable that we are getting. So we have initialized the result with a int minimum, that is minus infinity. So that's how this solution works. So it uses three for loops. So the time complexity becomes O of n cube, and space complexity stays constant, that is O of 1, because we are not using any array to store the result. So we are only using some variables to store the result and the three for loops. So if the interviewer is satisfied with this approach, then it is good. But if he tells you to optimize the approach further, so first of all we will see some concept. So for the getting the next solutions, the optimized ones, so we have to know these things. First of all, at any point of that index, we have three choices to make. First choice is that current element is greater than the maximum element. As I told you, maybe that your sub array product is minus 10 and your current element is 1, so then your result will be 1. So that's how it works. And the second condition is of current element, that is 1, multiply by the maximum product till that index minus 1, that is if the current element is 3, then the maximum at this previous index is 1, so then it will be, result can be 1 into 3, that is 3 can be our maximum product. Or either there may be a case when we have our current element into minimum product till that index minus 1, that is a minimum product at this index, that is minus 4, is minus 10. So minimum product is minus 10. I'm just taking example. Then it will be like minus 10 multiply by minus 4 will be 40. So that may be also a maximum maximum variable that we are searching for, maximum product. So that may happen. So we have to also consider the negative index, because if we just consider this, if you think array is like this, so then if we consider this only, then it will be my 1 into 3, so that will be 3. So we will, if we multiply 3 with minus 4, that will be minus 12. So we will only consider the 3 case, that is we will have only value, maximum value, that is 3. So if we include minus 10 also, then minus into minus becomes positive, and this whole subarray will have a sum that is 40 or 40 into 3, so that will be 120. So that may occur. So that's why we have to also consider the negative product as well as maximum product as well as the current value that we are on the index, particular index. So first of all, I will show you the dynamic programming approach. So in this approach, basically we have to initialize two arrays. Our first array will be the maximum DP, and the second array will be known as minimum DP. So we will have the maximum products in the first array and the minimum products in the second array for the previous indexes. So we are using a memorization technique that is a dynamic programming. So for that, we have to first of all set the first indexes. I will show you the dry run of this code so you will understand it better. So first of all, we will show the we will set the 0th index of the both arrays to the current element, that is 2, first index of the array, because at this 0th index we don't have any before any index before the 0. So that's why the maximum product till that will be the current element, that is 2. So that's why we have initialized flow to that. Now I will iterate from 1 to n minus 1, so it will start from 1. So we if I is at this index, so I is at 0 1 index, so element is 3. So our current element is 3, so it is less than 0, no. So we will skip this condition and we will enter into this condition, that is else part. So now element is greater than 0, so yes, it is true. So now we will our maximum of DP, that is max, I will use max variable, max is also same as this. Okay, I will write max equal to max DP of our I, that is 1, will be equal to the max of the current, that current value is 3, comma, this is current value, comma, the current value multiply by the, sorry, this one, current value multiply by the previous product that we have got. So current value is 3 and the previous current value multiply by the previous product, which is minus 2 at the previous index, that is I minus 1, and I is 1, so I minus 1 will be 0, so that it that is at this index. So the maximum out of both will be 6. So now we will set our this value to 6. For the minimum DP, we will use the minimum of the, we will get the minimum of both. So it is similar for this index, so it is minimum. Okay, so it will be minimum of 1, that is equal to the minimum of, that is current value, that is 3, multiply by number of I, 3, multiply by the minimum DP I minus 1, that is at 0th index, it is also 2. So minimum of them will be 3. So now our value will be 3 here. So now why we have used this condition is to handle the negative cases. That is, if we get the minus 2 value, we will use this condition. So now I have iterated to the next element, that is index 1 or 2. So now if we check this condition, the number of I is less than 0. So yes, it is true. So minus 2 is less than 0. So now we will enter into this condition. So now just let me erase this. And at index 2, our value is less than 0. So that is minus 2 is less than 0. So now we will enter into this condition, and our maximum of DP of 2 will be max of the current value, that is minus 2, multiply by the minus 2, that is current value, into the previous value of the minimum, that is 3. Why we are using 3 here? First of all, I will show you the answer. First of all, answer will be minus 2 here. Because why now we are using the minimum here and we are using maximum here? Because you know, as the minimum value we multiply with the minus value will be the maximum that we can get. If you multiply 6 with minus 2, then value will be minus 12. So minus 12 will be lesser than 3 multiplied by 2, that is minus 2, that is minus 6. So that's why we have used the negative value here. So it was the reason why we are maintaining the minimum DP array, to get the maximum product that we can get if we get the negative value also. So we have got the minus 2 value over here, so I will change it to the minus 2. And for the negative index, for the negative DP array, that is minimum DP of 2 will be minimum of the current value, that is minus 2, multiplied by the maximum value that we have, maximum value into minus 2, current value into maximum value at the previous index, that is 6. So it will be now minus 12. So now we have it will be minus 12, as minus 12 is lesser than minus 2. So that's why we are getting the lowest value that we can get, lowest possible value. So now the I increments to the next index, that is 4, index 3, and element is 4. So now we enter into this next iteration, then this condition is not true. So we enter into this condition, that is else part. Now we check for the maximum DP, that is max of DP and index is 3. So it will be maximum value out of the current value, that is 4 multiply by the previous maximum value, which is minus 2. So previous maximum value at the previous index is minus 2. So it will be, so our maximum value will stay 4, because 4 is the current element's value. So that is minus 8 is less than 4. So our maximum value that we can get is 4. So it will be 4. Now we, for the minimum DP array, that is minimum of DP 3 will be initialized to minimum of the current value. Current minimum is 4. The and 4 multiplied by the previous value at that previous value, that is minus 12. So 4 multiplied by minus 12 will be 48. So the minimum value that we can get from this is minus of 48. So this index will be initialized to minus 48. So that was it. Now for getting the result we use a maximum DP. For the getting result, we use maximum DP, that we have to traverse once again in this array. So our array is 2, 6, minus 2, 4. So the maximum out of these is 6. So our result will be 6. So you can see we have found our result, that is 6. So 2 into 3 is 6. So this is how we use DP. And suppose if we have a negative element here, that is after 4, we have 1, minus 1. Suppose that, just a second. After 4, suppose we have minus 1. Okay, we have got minus 1. For now, we have our element is lesser than 0. So we will enter into this condition. And this condition states as the maximum of this index will be the maximum of the current element, that is minus 1, into the maximum of minimum array, that is minimum DP I minus 1. So that is minus 48. So it will be minus 48. So you can see it minus 48 into minus 1 will be 48. So now we have got our maximum product as 48. So why we have got this? Because we have also maintained the minimum possible sum, that product that we can get. So that's why minus. So we take all the we include all the negative elements also. The if we get two negative elements in a pair, then we will get a positive value. So that may be larger than the sum, greater than the sum we are getting. So this index will be initialized to some value, but we have got the result. So I was showing you for that purpose. So now what would be the time complexity? Time complexity, we are using only one iteration for this. So one loop for this, that is traversing the array, and second loop for finding the maximum element out of the maximum DP array. So that's why our time complexity will be 2 into n, that will be n, similar to n. And our space complexity will be also n, because we are maintaining two arrays of size n, that is n is the size of array elements. So that's why we are getting this complexity. Now if your interviewer tells you to optimize the approach further and decrease the space complexity using if he asks you to solve the quotient using constant space, so then also we are using the concept that is either the element is greater, the current element, or the current element multiplied by the maximum product to the previous before the current element, and or it may be that current element into minimum product before the that element. So that the other three cases that we have to see for. So now our constant space solution uses three variables, basically two variables, that is two choices, and the third variable is our the current element only. So then we have to initialize three variables, that is minimum of current to the first in first value of that array, that is 2. So I have used maximum current as maximum here, so it will be initialized to the first element, that is 2, and the minimum of current, that is minimum here, it will be initialized also to 2, and result will be also 2. The result will be our final variable, so we won't have to traverse once again to find the result, the maximum result. So we are only traversing one time in this loop also, so it is also improving our time complexity if we have a larger array. So that's why it is a better solution. So now we have initialized our three variables, so we have three choices to make at every point. So that is the current element is greater, that is this element for example, and we have two choices, that is maximum into the current element, it will be c1, and the minimum into current element, that will be c2 into the current element. So it may work like that. So if you enter, first of all I will show you the dry run of this code. So we start with the first index, that is I is equal to 1. So our I is 1, first of all, just a second, our I is equal to 1. So I at 1 index, that is 3, element is 3. So our choice 1, C1 will be maximum of the previous, this is maximum current is this one, 2. So 2 multiply by our that particular index that we are on, that is 3. So it will be 6. So choice 1 is 6. So we will initialize this to 6. And the choice 2 is, this will be null because we are not using it here. So we have initialized the choice variables in the loop. So they will keep changing according to the values. So now choice 2 will be, C2 will be the current value, that is 3, multiplied by the minimum of minimum current, that is minimum value here. So it will be 2, that will be also 6. So now our maximum variable, that is max current, will be initialized to maximum of the current value, that is 3, and the product that we have got, the choice 1 and the choice 2. So maximum of this is 6, and the maximum out of all 3, that is 3, 6 and 6, maximum out of these is 6. So our maximum variable will be set to 6. Now after minimum variable will be the minimum value out of these 3, that is 3, 6, 6. So minimum is 3, so it will be set to minimum, and the result will be maximum of the max variable and the previous result, that is 6. So now our I iterates to the next value, that is minus 2. Now the minus 2, that is current value, multiply by the previous it is previous value, that is max value, it is 6. So it will be minus 12, and the current value multiply by the minimum value, that is minus 2, okay, multiply by the minimum value, that is 3, it is 3, it will be minus 6. So now we have got our choice 1 and choice 2 for the second iteration of this loop. Now we will just write it over here, minus 12, and we have got minus 12, and here we have got minus 6. So now our maximum variable will be maximum out of these 3. So out of these 3, the maximum value that we can get is minus 2. So it is current value. So here in this iteration, our first condition is working, that is either current element is greater than the these two variables. So that's how we use this condition. Now for the minimum value, it will be minimum of all 3. The minimum is minus 12, so it will be minus 12, and our result is will be maximum of 6, that is previous result and the maximum variable. So minus 2 is lesser than 6, so result will stay as it is, that is minus 12, and result will be 6 only. So now I iterates through the next element, that is 4. So now our value will be current variable, that is 4, multiply by the previous maximum, that is minus 2, that is the current the variable we have stored. So it will be minus 8. So we have got minus 8 over here, we have got minus 8. Now our choice 2 will be current variable, that is 4, multiplied by minimum variable, that is minus 12. So it will be minus 48. So our current the choice 2 will be minus 48. So now our maximum variable will be maximum of all 3, so maximum is 4. So we have wrote 4, we will write 4 here. So now minimum will be minimum of all 3, so minimum is minus 48, and the maximum will stay as it is because it is 6 is greater than 4, so it will be 6 only. So now why we use the negative variable? So now we will see its use, basic use. So in all these indexes we were using only the maximum. Now if you see, if we multiply maximum variable, that is 4, by minus 1, so the value will be minus 4, so it will become less. But if we see current index also, it is minus 1, it is also less. So if you see, if you multiply the minus 48 with the minus 1, it will be 48. So actually it will be greater than 48. So we have first of all we will make the choices. So we multiply the maximum variable, so it will be minus 4, and we will have 48. So how we got 48? Because we have included both the negative variables also using the minimum value. So negative into negative will become positive, so we may get the bigger value than the current result that we are having. So that's why we maintain the negative value. So now our maximum variable will be 48, and our minimum variable out of all 3 will be minus 4. Just like minus 4. So So it will be minus 4 and our result will be initialized to 48. So that's why we use the minimum variable also to maintain the. It is similar to Kitean's algorithm, a bit similar, like not too much similarity is there, but we are using two variables and there we were using one variable for maintaining the sum of the array, subarray. Now we are using two variables to maintain the product of the largest product that we can get and the minimum product we can get. So in this approach, we use only O(n) time complexity or time only one traversal, and we use constant space because we are only using five variables, that is current choice 1, choice 2, and the maximum, minimum, and the result for outputting our results. So that's how this solution works. I will show you the code now in the LeetCode platform. So as we have read the question description. So first I will show you the this approach that is using DP. So in this I have initialized two vectors, maximum DP and minimum DP, with the size of the array. Now I have set the first indexes, that is zero indexes of both, to the zeroth element of the array, the original array. Now we will iterate for the loop, and we have seen these conditions actually how they works, and then we will result the maximum value out of the max DP array. So I have used a inbuilt function in the C plus. So basically I have given the starting of the array and the ending of the array. So now we'll see how if it works or not. Let's see. So yes, it got accepted. Now we will submit the solution and see. Checking time. So yes, it ran, and you can see it takes 80. It is faster than 80.99% of solutions, and it takes less memory than 5.14%. That's why we use the constant space, because now we are getting the space issues. So I will just comment this solution. I will share this code in the description. You can download it from there or take it for your reference. So the next solution that we used is using the constant space. So this is our solution for the code for that problem. Just a second. So here we have initialized three variables, that is maximum current, minimum current, and the result that we will output. Now we will check if the size of the array is equal to 0, then we will return -1, and we will start for I is equal to 1 from the first index, as we have seen, to then we will keep finding the choices. I have wrote the code like this because it will be easier for you to understand. Otherwise we can compress this into this maximum only. So now we will make choices, our choices, that is C1 and C2, and then we will find the maximum out of all the choices and the current element. Then we will find the minimum out of all the choices and the current element, and then we will set up a result. So now let's run the solution and we will return our result. So you can see it got accepted. Now we'll submit the solution and see if it works faster than the DP or not. So yes, you can see the solution is faster. It takes only it is faster than 98.48% of solutions in C++, and it takes less memory than 9. Let's submit it again and see if the space complexity increases. So yes, you can see now time complexity decreased actually, but our space complexity increased. So it takes 84.21% less space than the other solutions. So that was it, guys, for this video. Do like this video and subscribe this channel, and do comment down below if you understood something from this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Thank you.